GamesWeasel.com. Review.
Right from the off, you can tell Facebreaker keeps its tongue firmly in its rather swollen cheek. It's a boxing game, but unlike the Fight Night games, which attempt to accurately portray boxing as a sport, complete with both analog controllers representing fists, Facebreaker does away with anything to do with boxing and is basically just a fighting game set in a boxing world. Fighting is instead very simple. You can punch high or low, parry high or low, or dodge high and low and come back with a super punch. String together some hits and a meter fills up at the bottom of the screen. Press the breaker button, and if you land a hit, you do a special move which can result in a KO or perform a face breaker, which ends the game in your favor there and then. You can also throw people for good measure too. The characters are all bright and colourful, and you can even upload your own face and even those of famous people to stick on a boxer's body. Looking online, the usual favourites of Borat, Hitler, Michael Jackson, etc. have been done, as well as the Joker. Some people are very talented indeed. You can download these or upload your own creations to share. This is actually a really neat feature, and it's actually lots of fun just playing with this mode alone. There is a fundamental problem with the game though, and that is, the combat is just way too simple and tires very quickly. The game's blisteringly quick and also really tough and frustrating even on the easy fierce mode when playing against AI opponents. It's tricky to form a strategy when you're under the cosh of the AI players, and instead you just end up hammering the buttons desperately trying to get a block or parry in so you can unleash some haymakers yourself. You'll have much more fun playing this online against real people, where a rhythm soon develops between punches and parries, and you get satisfaction out of knocking your friends into the middle of next week. Facebreaker could have been a contender, but it's definitely no Ready to Rumble. If Afro Thunder faced up against it, he'd definitely be asking someone to call a doctor. Facebreaker gets a good 6 out of 10.
You've been watching a review from GamesWeasel. If you want to get the show each week, which includes video game reviews, news, previews, competitions, and special features, then head over to GamesWeasel.com for our video podcast, GamesWeasel TV. GamesWeasel.com.